Hi, I'm Tom Alwyn, and welcome to Invasive Species, The Basics. I'm an aquatic biologist with the Department of Environmental Quality, working in the Aquatic Invasive Species Program. Today, I'm going to introduce you to some basic invasive species concepts. Invasive species impact every resident in Michigan to some degree, and it's important for everyone to learn about invasive species and take action. An invasive species can come in many forms. It can be something that lives on the land or something that lives in the water. It can be a plant or an animal. It can even be a microbe. The important thing to know about an invasive species is that it causes harm and it's not native. However, there are many non-native species that provide benefits to Michigan. The honeybee is a great example. Native to Europe, it provides us with many benefits. Its close cousin, however, the African bee or killer bee, is considered invasive due to its aggressive nature. Generally speaking, the greater the invasive species population, the greater the impact it will have. A good example is the feral swine, an invasive species that can cause considerable damage to forests, croplands, and water resources. They can also host diseases that threaten humans, wildlife, and livestock. While one hog can certainly cause damage, a group of swine can cause extensive damage. Invasive species damage can be categorized into three main areas: the economy, the ecosystem, and human health. Invasive species can have a negative economic impact in two main ways. The first is economic loss, which is loss that does not involve physical damage. An investment that results in losing money is an example of economic loss. The second economic impact is management and control costs, which is just as it sounds, the cost to control or manage an invasive species. To put this in perspective, let's talk about Eurasian water milfoil, an aquatic invasive plant that is widespread in Michigan. A study conducted in Washington State focused on economic loss caused by this invasive lake species. The study was published in 2014 and compared property values around lakes without Eurasian water milfoil to lakes with Eurasian water milfoil. They found that property values on lakes with Eurasian water milfoil were 19% lower on average than comparable property on non-infested lakes. In addition to reducing property value, Eurasian water milfoil can also inflict economic losses for businesses. Infestations that impede recreation on a lake can hurt sales of local businesses. Additionally, lake groups that choose to combat the infestation to reduce those negative impacts incur management and control costs. Once Eurasian water milfoil becomes established, management and control often become a long-term endeavor. That's one reason why preventing the introduction of invasive species is vital. The cost to manage and control aquatic plants using chemicals in Michigan has been estimated to be $24 million per year. At the national scale, the cost in terms of economic loss and management and control costs for all terrestrial and aquatic invasive species is estimated to be as high as $137 billion per year. It's clear that invasive species can have a big economic impact, but now let's look at how they can impact the environment. Once an invasive species becomes established, it will often displace native species, and it may even dominate the habitat. Pictured here is garlic mustard, an herbaceous plant that grows in forests and urban areas. Garlic mustard roots release chemicals that alter the soil, which harms native trees and plants. Once established, it competes with tree seedlings for available light, nutrients, and water, preventing new trees. Garlic mustard has no known wildlife benefits, deer don't eat it, and it's toxic to some insects. In addition to outcompeting and or crowding out native species, some invasive species are pests that feed on and kill native species. The emerald ash borer is an example of a species established in most of the state. Surprisingly, the larvae of the emerald ash borer inflict the most damage as it feeds on the inner bark of the tree. These little things are responsible for killing tens of millions of ash trees in Michigan. Where present, the emerald ash borer decimates ash tree populations. But there are ash stands in the state that haven't been impacted by this invasive insect. Unlike the emerald ash borer, the Asian longhorn beetle has not been found in Michigan, but has been observed in nearby states. It feeds at a number of trees, including maple, oak, and beech. If it becomes established in Michigan, the damage it could do to forests and urban trees would be devastating, and control options are limited. Therefore, preventing the introduction of the Asian longhorn beetle is crucial. So now you know, invasive species can damage or ruin local economies and the environment. But what about human health? Depicted here is a sea lamprey on a German horror film's promotional poster. Invasive species are sometimes sensationalized in pop culture as dangerous and life-threatening.
Oh, that is hard. That is hard to get off.
This is rarely the case. The truth is, sea lamprey are a fish parasite and don't bother people. It's rare for invasive species to directly harm human health. There are, however, a few invasive species that can directly harm a human. One such example is the sap of a plant called giant hogweed. Upon contact with human skin, the sap can cause blistering and scarring. Thankfully, giant hogweed is rarely found in Michigan. There are several native plant species that can be misidentified as giant hogweed. If you think you've found giant hogweed, avoid touching it. If you want to learn more, there are great resources out there. A great place to start is michigan.gov/invasive-species. The site provides information on invasive species that are specific to Michigan. You can also find out about laws, permitting, grants, volunteer opportunities, and more. Remember, even if an invasive species is widespread, it doesn't mean it's everywhere. So stay tuned for more videos on invasive species and how you can stop them from spreading. Thanks for watching.